Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this simple basket mold in SOLIDWORKS with the help of mold tools, and here we will create two more extra core for this basket hole. So let's see how to make this beautiful basket with mold. Let's start to make basket mold for a basket first, then mold. This basket size is 150 by 100 millimeter and height is 60 millimeter. See, and the angle of extrusion is 6 degree. That's it. Then you will see there is a hollow shape inside line 2 millimeter shell command. We will use this outer radius R5. Top plane is sketch, center rectangle. 100, press tab, 150, enter, fill it, 10 millimeter, select full rectangle, see all corner become sketch fillet, extrude. Now this extrude keep end condition blind, 60 millimeter, see, but here draft angle 6 degree, it's going inside, click outward draft. That's it. Fill it. 5 millimeter this bottom. Okay. Now let's try shell. Here keep thickness 2 millimeter and here we need to choose this face. Click show preview. You will be easily view the preview. Now see. Now I'll select this face, sketch. Now I'll click this line, select tangency. See, the full tangency selected. Offset entity, 12 millimeter. Okay, but this also we need to keep, right click, select tangency, convert entity. Extrude 2 millimeter, reverse direction, angle keep here 6 degree. See, if I'll show you section view, see perfectly aligned. Now here see 12 millimeter the distance. Then there is outer radius R2, okay. Then there is a hole, this 8 diameter hole, 15 and 10 millimeter distance from outer. This is 8 number of holes, 14 distance. And vertically, 4 number of patterns, but distance is 12 millimeter, okay. We will create this both side, then we will go for mold. Now, fill it. 2 millimeter and choose this edge. That's it. Select this face, sketch, circle. Now here hole 8, enter, distance 15 and the distance from upper edge 10 millimeter. See, extruded cut and here keep end condition to next. So that it will cut only up to wall. Now let's use circular pattern and create multiple linear pattern, sorry. The whole feature is selected, direction. Let's select this horizontal direction, not face, okay. Any edge, that's fine. We need 8 number of holes. 14, direction 2, I'll choose this line, vertical line, reverse, 12 number of gaps between the holes, even though we can create 5 also, but let's avoid it and we will go according to our drawing. Okay, let's do one thing, make 14 so that we will get enough space. Okay, now click mirror, linear pattern, mirror, and here choose plane, plane to mirror, front plane. You will see the preview. Okay, that's the our mold part is created. Now let's try to, okay, better we will apply material at the, now first right click, choose your mold tool. First I'll choose draft analysis. Here we need to choose our pull direction. So this is the our pull direction. See, there is no yellow color edge, because if yellow, then you need to define draft. 6. Okay. Now exit. Now scale, material will shrink. Keep centroid 1.02. Okay. See. So our cavity become a little bigger than this because material will shrink. Now let's apply here parting line. I know this is our face. 6 degree draft analysis. See, here all the edges automatically select. See, outer edge automatically select. Sometime we need to select manually, but this time it's selected. See, pull of direction arrow shows upward. Now there is a hole, so we need to close this hole because we want to create a core for this hole also. So we will close the hole from inside. So there is tool shut off surfaces. See, automatically it's selected. Now if we see close view, see it is selected both the edges. So right click and clear all, clear section. And let's choose manually inside edge. So I'll skip this sketch, this, so that we will save our time. Now here we selected all inside edges. So simply say OK. Once you say OK, it will take few seconds and you will see all inside block, but outer one is open because we are going to create a separate core. Now let's the next thing, parting surface. Now here I'll put the distance. Parting surface always bigger than the mold size. Here I'll choose smooth so that we will get perfect shape. Say OK. Now I'll select this top face, the sketch. Okay. Now I'll create center rectangle. 210 plus tab key. Okay, now exit, go to mold tool and choose your tooling split. If you see section view, it's going to create the upper distance dimension. See, depth in direction 135 and the other one 90 millimeter. This covers our mold. That's perfect. Now here core, cavity, parting surface, everything is shown here. Okay, now let me hide. Now I'll hide the line also. Now I'll show you. Let's hide this part. See, let me hide the basket also. See, this is core. If you drop down here, you will find, let's show hide. See, this is the R. Okay, mold hide. Okay, this is the our cavity. Now we with the help of this, we will create separate core. So let's see how. So upper one I'll show, lower one hide. Parting material or parting line show. Now do one thing, click on this basket sketch, and here I'll create rectangle. Tab 48, 115. Millimeter. Now let's define a vertical line, connect say origin point or midpoint, click the line. See, this is fully defined. Exit and go to mold. Here find core. We need to create core, extract core. So I'll select core. Now face clear, and I'll choose one bottom, not face, any vertical horizontal line. See, and here in parting line delete, we need to choose core, cavity, and here select through all. You will see cancel and cap. Now here we forget to delete and choose tool, this one. Okay, perfectly. See, it is parallel to our cavity. See through wall. Okay. Now here is created. If you check, see, show. See, if I'll hide this one, now look, now let's again create some more thing. So I'll select again this face sketch. I'll choose the previous sketch, convert entity. It is converted. Exit, core, delete this. Now here any horizontal line or vertical, make sure it's line, not face. Okay. Now here I'll choose previous core, body. This is the core. Through all. Now see, it's going to make up to end of the body. You will see here, we selected core. You must choose core, not cavity. End condition through all. Cancel and cap. Okay. Now, if you check here, you will see two cores. Show. Look, if I'll hide this component, let's refresh. See. Now let's show all the component. So basically our mold is created. Let's save first this one. Go to desktop, create new folder. Basket mold. This is now right click on the body, save bodies. Now here select auto assign, here create assembly, browse assembly, you can choose your location, what we decide, basket mold, save. Now click yes. Now it will ask you some conditions, so say yes and save and build. Now if you drop down the window and here you will find basket. Oh look. Now this is the which one top? The top one. Let's assign color. Okay. This is the side one. Green. This is the basket body. Basket, let's choose red. This is our cavity. Cavity, let's say yellow. And the last part. Green. Now, let's do one thing. Let's make a exploded view and we will see how it save. Yes, all exploded view. First I'll explode this one, take upside, done. Now choose here radial step 1, 2, these two outer one, drag, done. Linear, upside, done. Okay. Right click, collapse, right click. Animate exploded view. See how we created a simple mold in SolidWorks with the help of mold tools. And here we created two more cavities for this. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.